Okay, now let's move on to talk about the next important concept called conditioning. In practice, we often encounter this kind of situation that we have a probability model for some situation, but then we made some observation or something happened and it changed this probability model. For example, if we observe that it was raining today, then the probability of tomorrow being a rainy day would certainly change. If we observe some information about a certain company today, then the probability that its stock price would increase tomorrow would be different. All right, how do we address this in our formal mathematical language? This is about conditioning. Now let's go back to this familiar picture of a general sample space omega. Suppose we have a probability model all built up. Let's call that omega p. And there are two events in general, A and B. They could have some intersection, and depending on where the outcome fall, we say event A occurs, event B occurs, or both A and B occurs. Yeah? So that's a familiar picture. Now suppose that we have an observation that A occurred. What does that mean? That means the outcome of the random experiment omega, we know that it lies in A. Now this would change the picture. How does it change the picture is that we should not be worrying about this overall sample space anymore. Anything out of A, we don't care, because they don't happen anymore. Right? This is the only thing that we should be worrying about. And here we still have a set A that become our new sample space. We still have the set from omega not changed to A. We still have this set of possible outcomes. We still don't know exactly where the outcome would be. And therefore, there should be a new sample space, a new model, and a new probability assignment. The original, let's call that P. Now this new one, we will call that P condition on A. This is the probability, conditional probability, condition on event A occurs. Now how would we write this out mathematically? For any omega, any possible outcome from the original picture, the probability of this particular outcome, condition on A, there could be two different cases. If omega is not in A, then that would change into, if you observe A, that means omega has to be in A, but for any omega that's not in A, that's never going to occur anymore. So the probability goes to zero. And if omega is in A, we have probability of omega of this. Well, this should be the chance for this particular outcome should increase. We write that as probability, the original probability of this divided by probability of event A. Why do we want to scale with this 1 over P of A? This is so that to guarantee sum over all the omega in this A, this new sample space, this new space of all possible outcomes, probability of omega, condition on A, that's precisely equal to 1. We scale everything up, renormalize this so that we get a valid probability assignment on this new sample space, which was A.